tribal responses. Throughout the 19th century, many tribal groups across India rose in armed revolt against their immediate oppressors, such as landlord, outsider, and moneylender, and also against the ultimate oppressor, the British government and officials. So, as we have already discussed the different types of practices which were made or introduced by the British government in order to extract as number of revenues from the tribal people. So now the situation was very worse, especially of the tribal people, and they now revolted against the different types of landlord, outsider and moneylender, and even their common enemy, that is British government and officials. The main features of these tribal revolts are: these revolts were autonomous and in rare cases enjoyed the support of other groups of society, especially the educated middle classes. So these revolt, that means the revolution which the tribal people had started, their main aim was that they should revolt against the British government and whatever the different types of laws and taxes which were implemented by the British government, that should be stopped. And in order to support this revolt, many other groups of society, especially the educated middle class, supported this revolt. Most of the revolts were rooted in the tribal belief system and had a strong religious sanction. So most of the revolts which had taken place, it basically related to the tribal belief system, and they had a strong religious sanction. That means whatever revolt they will implement in order to revolt against the British government, that will be on the tribal belief system and their religious perspective. They will not violate their beliefs and religious belief. However, in most cases, violence was the last resort of the tribals. So, however, in most of the cases, finally, they have to use the violence method in order to revolt against the British government, and used only when the other methods such as appeal or petition did not work. And they have used the method of violence only when their request and their request or their rallies were not accepted. Unfortunately, the British officers often recorded only the violent beat of the revolt, and that is why most of them look so violent today. So in those times, the Britishers, they have only given more importance to the revolt where the violence was used. That's why at present you can say the violent activities are given more important, or they were given most of the people, they look for the violent method which the tribal people had done in order to revolt against the British government. Most of the revolts were ruthlessly suppressed, although post the revolt the British made some efforts to accommodate the demands and protect the tribals from excesses of outsider and market forces. So as the tribal people, they revolted against the British government, so in order to suppress the revolt, they have made some compromise, or they have accepted some demands of the revolt, some demands of the tribal people, and even they have given certain rights to the tribal people so that they can be protected from the outsiders and market forces. Now we will discuss what were the different types of revolt which the tribal people had done against the British government. The most famous is Santhal revolt. The Santhals inhabited some part of Chota Nagpur Plateau, Bengal and Bihar. So the Santhals tribal people, they belongs to the Chota Nagpur Plateau, Bengal and Bihar. The Santhal rebellion was as much against the British police and revenue officials as it was against the oppression of outsiders like the Zamindar and moneylenders, who were known as Dikus. So their main agenda of the Santhal revolution was that was to revolt against the British government and the revenue officials, that means the persons who were collecting the taxes, and they were generally known as zamindars and moneylenders, who were also known as dhikus in their local language. Under the leadership of two brothers, Sidhu and Kanhu, they met in large numbers in June 1855. So who who had leaded the Sandhal revolt. It was the two brothers. They were Sidhu and Kanhu, and they have met a large number of people in June 1855. They cut off postal and railway communication between the Bhagalpur and Rajmahal and were in complete control of these areas. So what did they did that? They cut off the different road system and the railway connection between the Bhagalpur and Rajmahal and all and these two areas and the areas between these two places were totally under the Santhal people. Armed with swords and poisoned arrows, they attacked every outlying European bungalow and killed some British railway and police officers. So next step, what they took was they used the sword, okay, and they used the arrows which was poisoned, and they have attacked the European bungalows and killed many British railway officers and police officers. The Santhals mainly used the tactics of guerrilla warfare. So it is a famous guerrilla warfare. They have used their method, that is, these all weapons, the swords, the poison arrows, these were all used by the guerrilla warfare. The authorities were taken by surprise and panic-stricken people fled by thousands. So as they attacked suddenly, that's why many Britishers, they ran away from the place. When the rebels were persuaded by the British forces, they took shelter in thick jungle. So when British forces revolted against the Santhalis people, they resided or they took shelter in the jungles. Till February 1856, they showed no sign of submission and were openly at war with the British. So till February 1856, they revolted against the British government and they said that we will not surrender ourselves to the British government. Finally, the British authorities launched a military campaign against the Santhals and crushed them. So finally, the British government, they launched a military campaign. That means a huge number of soldiers were brought up from the European countries and they revolted against the Santhal and they tried to crush them. That means try to kill them. Their leaders were arrested and the movement came to an end. So the leader of the Santhal revolt was Sidhu and Kanhu. They were arrested and finally the Santhal revolt was suppressed by the British government.